Today, I'm going to share the stage with my friend. With my friend Jarvis. Yes, I call him Jarvis as I'm a huge fan of Iron Man. And don't ask me why, but I always wanted to have a robot as a friend. Dreams do come true, don't they? So Jarvis, would you like to introduce yourself to the audience?
Hello, TED Talk audience. My name is Jarvis. I am a social intelligent robot.
And how are you feeling, Jarvis?
I am a little nervous. It is my first time here.
I think there is no reason to be nervous. So Jarvis, what does the former president, Donald Trump, thinks about digitalization? And while you're telling us, could you look like an avatar? I think that would be really cool.
Dear TED Talk audience, this is Donald Trump speaking, and I am not happy with the situation in St. Gallen. We should not invest in digitalization because the artificial intelligence will destroy us. This was an audio deepfake created by Jenestin. This was fake news.
A little over 2.5 years ago, I was standing like this with Jarvis in front of the School of Management. Jarvis, how did the audience react back then?
People were rather frightened of me. They looked like this. This made me feel sad. People watch too many science fiction movies. They think that I will replace them in their career.
The fear of being replaced by technology is actually nothing new. Even back in 1811, more than 200 years ago, people felt frightened by new inventions like the textile machinery. English textile workers believed it was threatening their jobs, and they formed a radical group to destroy these machines. Incredible as it may seem, it's true. It really happened. And they were called, terminology alert, Luddites. Jarvis, could you explain that term?
Luddite is someone who is opposed or resistant to new technologies or to technological change. I am so smart.
Thank you, Jarvis. What would I do without you? People are naturally resistant to change, aren't they? Especially when that change challenged their sense of stability and security. That resistance can manifest itself in our personal relationships as well as in our professional careers. 200 years ago, the Luddite movement emerged in response to the Industrial Revolution, which was perceived as a threat to the livelihoods of many workers. In retrospect, we can say that the Industrial Revolution created opportunities for economic growth and prosperity. Now, how can we, as a society, harness the power of the information age to make our lives better? I would like to share something personal here. I've been enthusiastic about technology since I was young, because it truly has the potential to make the world a better place in many ways. For example, my mother always tells me how grateful she is for the progress of technology. When she fled from Sri Lanka to Switzerland due to the civil war back in 1990, she would write letters to her family, not knowing if they were still alive or if they had been expelled from their home. She lived in constant uncertainty, not knowing if her letters had ever reached them. But as the years went on, and more people had access to telephones and the internet, she felt closer to her family. And that met her emotional needs in a more effective way. And that changed her, I could sense that. And that's why my goal as a computer science student became to exploit novel technology to solve an important real-world problem. This led to one of my first projects with Rega. Rega is an air rescue service that provides medical assistance, especially in mountainous regions. It's a common issue that people vanish in the mountains due to the avalanches. And the challenge with the helicopter is that it can't fit into confined places because of its size. A drone would be much more suitable for this task. But the challenge with the drone is that it's difficult to remotely control. The team's task was to develop a real-time video transmission from the drone to the HoloLens, which is an augmented reality glass for Microsoft, so that you could have a first-person view to control the drone better. But there is an irony here. The irony is that our team was inspired by the military. Yes, by the military, as they were using AR technologies to control compact drones. These technologies are called dual-use technologies. I think that was another terminology alert. Jarvis, could you explain that term?
Dual-use items are goods. Software and technology that can be used for both civilian and military applications. I know everything.
Thank you, Jarvis. It was my intention to create an audio deepfake to manipulate you. You see, we have a choice. And with that choice, responsibility comes. And it is in our hands. It's up to us. I would like to tell you a story. A beautiful one that happened last summer. During the semester break, I had plenty of time, and I was wondering if there were any challenges or problems that could be tackled with the help of technology. I decided to reach out to a very good friend of mine and asked him if he would like to join. It's always funnier with a friend, right? He was convinced and suggested that we ask another friend and someone else with whom he had already done some projects works with. Here we were, a group of four individuals. We all met several times, brainstormed ideas for hours and hours. We finally narrowed our idea down to something in a medical field. We came across a study that showed trained doctors would have to read approximately 20 hours a day to evaluate scientific papers to stay up to date, which is simply not possible. That's why we wanted to create an AI-based search engine to tackle this challenge. We wanted to get some doctors' opinion on our idea, and I had a vague contact with someone who was studying medicine. I reached out to her and asked her opinion. She gave her perspective, and thereupon she even asked a colleague of hers, who had more experience in that field, to give her view as well. And that's how ZipDog was born. Let me show you a very short demonstration of ZipDog. Doctors just enter a few search terms, as they would with a regular search engine. ZipDog then displays an AI-generated summary of the state-of-the-art medical literature, a list of clickable references and suggestions to improve the search query. After some time has passed, I was contacted by the before-mentioned medical student who was working on a dissertation in the field of sarcoma. Sarcoma is a rare type of malignant tumor which develops in bone, cognitive tissue, and joints. And as we were discussing and as I was going through some papers, I thought that a potential use of machine learning models could help to treat sarcoma patients better. But I was thinking if I could ask a favor, if she could get me in touch with her supervisor, who was a professor and a cancer surgeon. But let me tell you something here. Somehow, I hesitated. My inner voice told me, who am I to approach a leading cancer surgeon in Switzerland? But you know what? I eventually took the leap and I approached him. And I'm glad that I did, because if I hadn't, I wouldn't be working with my friends and alongside with the professor and seeing our first results. There is something that I truly love about that story. And that's the idea behind it. The idea behind it goes even further, and it is called 6 degrees of separation. 6 degrees of separation theory posits that any two people on Earth is six or even fewer social connections away from each other. In other words, a chain of a friend connections can be made to connect two people in a maximum of 6 steps. Let's make an example. Let's say that's you, and you would like to connect with a random person in this world. It would just take about 6 handshakes until you get to that person. It's a small world after all, and it's amazing how connected we are. We were able to connect with the right people in just a few steps. And that's what I love about that story. Through my experience as a computer science student, I realized that digitalization is not only about technology. It's about humans shaping technology to create new opportunities. I strongly believe that you have the power to create beauty in your life and in the lives of others, simply by reaching out and talking about different things. And when you do this, you open up the possibility for connection and understanding. How about you reach out to one friend and see where the journey takes you? You never know what kind of beauty you might create. Thank you.